Hey, good morning. It's Wednesday, 26th of August, it's 2020. John Hiley, a pastor serving at Grace Lutheran Church in Fairmont, Minnesota, here today with what I hope is a word of hope for anybody and everybody who needs to be encouraged in the middle of this day. We know there are challenges in our world, challenges that are real that we wish weren't here, but are here. And in the middle of knowing the challenges, I want to remember that God's love is with us, and that God's love transforms us and our whole world, and that God is doing something brand new with us and through us and for us right now. So I've been reading stories from the book of Acts, and these stories from Acts are full of encouragement from the earliest days of the church. And the story I want to share today is a story about Peter, one of Jesus' first followers, and a woman called Tabitha. Her Greek name was Dorcas. That Greek name Dorcas means dear. So I want you to imagine a woman who is much beloved by everybody in the early church. And this much beloved woman in the early church gets very sick and dies. So Peter's in another town called Lydda, and Dorcas is in Joppa. Peter gets the word and he goes as fast as he can to Joppa. He gets to the place where Dorcas's body is there. And he goes in and he sees that her body has been prepared like it should be. It was washed, it was wrapped. But he goes and he kneels down next to the body. He's put everybody out of the room and he prays. And then he says to Dorcas, he calls her by her name, Tabitha, get up. And the woman opened her eyes. And when she saw Peter, she sat up. He took her by the hand and helped her to her feet. And Peter called the widows and the other followers and showed them that Dorcas had been raised from the dead. And everyone in Joppa heard what had happened, and many of them put their faith in the Lord. I want to remember this story today. This story because I believe in the middle of the challenges that are real in our world, in the middle of fear and uncertainty and a pandemic, in a nation that is facing long-standing challenges, I believe that we as people of faith are called, like Peter did, to trust that God is with us right now. To trust that God is with us in our fears, in our worries, in our uncertainty. To trust that we are much loved and that God hasn't forgotten any of us or anyone for that matter. And I think this is our moment to be church, our moment to share a word of encouragement and hope with anybody and everybody who needs it. That the God of Peter 2,000 years ago is the God of our time, that God's love goes with us, and that we are not alone. So I encourage you today to pray. Pray a lot like Peter did. Pray full of hope that God can work something brand new in us. Pray for those who are sick today. Pray for those who are grieving today. Pray for those who work today in care of others, in group homes, nursing homes, hospitals, clinics. Pray for wisdom for yourself, for our nation, for people around us, that we may make wise decisions in this moment of pandemic, that we may be part of solutions and not part of problems. Well, peace, many blessings. Hope to hear from you.